Our Artemis I spacecraft is delivered for some critical testing, a big step for our commercial crew program, and a possible connection between dust storms and water loss on Mars. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. The Orion spacecraft for our Artemis I mission arrived in Ohio on November 24th aboard our Super Guppy aircraft. The spacecraft, which is comprised of the Orion crew module and European-built service module, will be tested at our Plum, Brook station in Sandusky, Ohio. The four-month test campaign will subject Orion to extreme environmental conditions similar to what it will experience during its three-week mission around the Moon and back to confirm all components and systems work properly under in-space conditions. Our partner Boeing has moved its CST-100 Starliner spacecraft to the launch pad at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida in preparation for its journey to the International Space Station on the company's uncrewed orbital flight test. It's part of our commercial crew program, which will again launch astronauts from American soil. The flight test, targeted for December 17th, will test Starliner, the Atlas V rocket, ground systems, and in-orbit docking and landing operations ahead of crewed missions that will carry astronauts to and from the space station. Data gathered by our fleet of spacecraft during the 2018 global dust storm on Mars is helping shed new light on a phenomenon called dust towers and their possible role in the disappearance of water from the Red Planet for billions of years. According to two recently published scientific papers, scientists think that water vapor on Mars gets trapped in these dust towers and is then carried upward, as if riding an elevator to space, where the water vapor is then lost through the upper atmosphere. Dust towers are seen throughout the Martian year, but appear to form in greater numbers during global storms. Towers that reach heights of about 50 miles, as seen during the 2018 global dust storm, can spread out to about the size of the state of Nevada. A new video series celebrates our 20th year of continuous human presence living off our home planet. Down to Earth features NASA astronauts discussing a shift in worldview as a result of their time in space aboard the International Space Station. Since the November 2, 2000 arrival of Bill Shepard, Sergei Krikalev, and Yuri Gidzenko, the station's first resident crew, there has been a continuous stream of humans living and working aboard the orbital outpost. For more about the video series, go to nasa.gov/station.
Thanksgiving, we think of
our current space station astronauts, Jessica Meir, Christina Koch, and Andrew Morgan, recorded a Thanksgiving message to talk about what they're thankful for and about some items on the menu for their Turkey Day dinner.
We've got vegetables, of course, green beans and potatoes that will warm up, and of course, smoked turkey in a pouch.
Cornbread dressing. This will be great. We can maybe stuff it inside the turkeys just to make it like a real stuffing.
I want to know who's going to carve the turkey once it comes out of that pouch.
We also have some mashed potatoes and corn, so it looks like we have a lot of good options. It's going to be quite a feast.
Happy Thanksgiving!
That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.